And yeah, this is like my very first Honkai Star Rail special program watching party. Cause yeah, I never really watched any of these like until now because I was like so behind in terms of like Star Rail. So hey, for those of you who are new, hey, what's up? My name's Space Edge and I stream Genshin and Star Rail. Mostly Star Rail nowadays because Genshin's like now in its downtime, at least until 4.4 comes out. But yes, this is what my current status is in Star Rail right now. I got all of these quests still unfinished. I got the Dr. Ratio, a trailblaze quest, which is like probably the only trailblaze quest I'm missing, which I like have not done yet. But once I'm done with this, I should be like perfectly caught up for like Penacony. But then there's also like a crap ton of companionship missions that I do have to do. Like a whole lot of them. Like one of these days I gotta like sit back and binge and just yeah watch all these or do all these quests at once. And not to mention like these other like side quests down here that I gotta catch up on. But yeah, hopefully it shouldn't be too much of an issue of me doing or watching the Honkai Star Rail 2.0 special program. But yeah, I'm going in basically blind because I have never seen a single Honkai Star Rail trailer or video like ever really. I've not viewed a single one except for Kafka's demo. That's the only one I viewed. Kafka's demo was the only Star Rail trailer I viewed. And yeah, I just haven't watched any of the others. So yeah, pretty much I'm just going into this blind. I have no idea who the new characters coming out in Penacony are. Or Penacony. I think that's how you pronounce it. Penacony. Yeah. I have no idea who the characters are coming out in the Penacony update. I know this Acheron and Aventurine, but that's basically it. I know nobody else, and you have zero clue what Penacony is all about because I'm just so behind in terms of Star Rail stuff. But hopefully I can catch up in due time before 2.0 comes out. But yeah, basically, I'm just going to be watching this special program alongside you guys, and I guess maybe if there's stuff I don't understand, you guys can just like fill me in of like what's going on and whatnot, just so I don't get too lost. I gladly appreciate if somebody decided to do that. Alrighty, but here we are. Version 2.0 of Honkai Star Rail is about to go live. I'm still in the Genshin mindset, if you cannot tell. But yes, going into this special program completely blind. I have no idea what's going to show in Penacony or Penacony. Okay, a countdown to the countdown, real slick Hoyo. Okay, so 2.0 is gonna show off like, yeah, Black Swan and Sparkle, right? And also that furina looking character. I forget their names, but here we go, beginning. If one jeans admit, wow. The way has drip, I see. Oh, what the fuck? Who the hell? What the hell? What the okay, this is already very different from the Genshin streams. What the hell? Honkai Star Rail has officially gone insane with the talking trash cans. What the fuck? Dawei is haunted by trash cans. who the hell is this clock guy? Or this mascot? What the fuck?
欢迎莅临 Penacony 这位先生。
Oh, that's how you get to Penacony. Just go on an acid trip. On an acid trip with trash cans. Oh shit, trailer, alright. Oh, that's a Venturine, right? Yeah. What the fuck? Oh, this is turning into a fucking Backstreet Boys music video. The hell? Just singing? Oh, who are these characters? Oh yeah, that's a new character that's coming in 2.0. Oh yeah, and what's his name? That was drip marketed. Sparkle, Black Swan. This music though. Oh, she looks adorable. I really want to know what their names are. I probably should look them up after this. Yeah, this is like a K-pop music video or something. Whoa, okay, that's what Penacony is. Oh yeah, very, very different from the other places. Holy shit, the music though. Oh yeah, there's a Acheron. Holy shit, this is hype. I fucking like this music, holy shit. Yeah, that's like an anime opening right now. Also, yeah, who the fuck is that clock and why are we wearing a hat? Yeah, that's a whole ass K-pop music video. What the hell? That was sick, actually. Yeah, this is very, very different from the Genshin livestreams. Okay, Hoyo, please put in the same amount of effort for the Genshin livestreams, would you? At least for Natlin. Oh no, no, not the lag! No! Okay, we're fine. Honkai picked the 6th anniversary, jeez. Okay, so this guy's been around for a while. Yeah, honestly, Penacony looks this damn sick though. It's a shame it's not like an open world game that we can explore it though. Yeah, but the Trailblazer. Yeah, where we originally were going to before Kafka so rudely interrupted us. Still over though. Yeah, I need to know the names of all the characters that were just shown there. This is like, yeah, watching the Inazuma live stream for the first time and like getting introduced to all the Inazuma characters and not knowing who the hell they are. The land of dreams. The family and sex invites to other factions. Oh, I thought we were going there because there's a Celeron stuff we have to do there. Maybe not then.
Whoa!
Nurse the Revere.
Oh,
it used to be a prison? And of course the IPC was behind it. When are they not behind anything? Damn, this looks like a whole ass hotel, yeah. The red carpets everywhere?
Yeah, it
looks super, super advanced compared to the space station and Yurilo. And it's Yensho, too. Whoa. I just noticed that the whales just swimming about. Are they holograms or are they like actual living creatures? Traversal planes between reality and dreams. What?
Huh.
Oh yeah, what about Eon is worshipped on Penacony? He said harmony. So maybe the Eon Harmony. What's the Eon Harmony's name again? Actually, we don't know, do we? Or at least I don't know. Maybe one of you guys can fill me in. Hey Zachary, welcome to stream, welcome. Oh, you're just saying hi before you go to school. That's fine though, thanks for stopping by.
Hmm.
Yes, the Trailblaze missions. Hey, okay, there's Sparkle. Yeah, all three characters are available in 2.0. Long days, journey into the night. Yeah, Sparkle, Black Swan, I forgot the blue hair boy's name. And yes, that is a boy. That's all I remember about him. I forgot their name. All I know is that all of them are playable in 2.0. I'm kind of tempted to get a Black Swan, I'm not gonna lie. Wait, one of the Celeron Hunters were there? Okay, it is the end of Harmony. Wait, who's the end of Harmony again? I think we know, but I'm forgetting. Shipei, I think it was? Or maybe I'm misremembering things. You guys can clarify. Oh yeah, what's with us doing a freaking music video with Aventurine? Like, what the hell? Are we gonna become like best friends or something? Why do I not believe you?
Oh, okay, so...
story's gonna go from 2.0 to 2.2. Kind of like how the Ark quests are going for Genshin. Yeah, don't be like an SAO. God, I wonder how long it takes for Hoyo to like set up these set pieces to just do a live stream in. Or maybe it's not just all CGI for all I know, but it looks real to me. Graphics cards, the hell?
当游客们来到黄金的时刻，就能感受到浓厚的
Was I reading that right? 这座城市奉行唐江主义的方式。Yeah, it's kind of like 80s, 90s inspired. Well, not, maybe not that far back. Like 70s, I guess, I think. Oh, yeah.
的确很繁华，那么荒诞者的又是什么呢？
It's like, yeah, 70s Vegas or something. That's the vibe I'm getting from all of Penacony. So glad. It's this region's Fanta. Is that? What? Did I just see an NPC wearing one of those plaster heads that Dr. Ratio wears? Yeah, this is literally like Vegas. At least that's what I think Vegas looks like. I don't know, I haven't been there. Never mind, totally Vegas with the What the, is that sign chasing us? What the hell? Ah, I don't like that. What the? Free money, hell yeah!
Oh, 他们都带着小绒球，很好分辨。一个个小小的，感觉就像小大人一样。嗯。
So those guys with the balls on their head are not human? Yeah, that clock looks a lot like Mickey Mouse, like inspired, like, yeah, it's like a Disney character. A cartoon IP in Penacony, Clocky and his friends. Totally not a ripoff of Mickey. I mean, Steamboat Willie Mickey is like public domain now, so guess he can do whatever the hell he wants. What the fuck? I love how we taken the freaking trash can joke, and it's just transcended beyond even the realm of reality in Honkai Star Rail.
在梦境世界探索过程中，开拓者还会遇到很多奇妙的景观。我们觉得地球上的生命发源于海洋，那种幽闭光怪陆离的视觉体验和。That's
probably like one of my most favorite running gags in Star Rail. It's just like all the trash can jokes.
波浪的光影效果，大家会在梦境中看到光怪陆离的会客厅，或者鲸鱼飞过的天空。
What the fuck? Okay, that's gonna be used for puzzles or something.
时间和重力是匹诺康尼两大重要元素，他们有时会因梦境而发生错乱。Trippy。同一个场景在现实和梦境的两个层面可能是完全不一样的。詹姆斯的同学们有心了啊！那我更加好奇了，在梦中的战斗与游玩体验是否会和之前的几个世界不一样呢？这是当然的，毕竟都已经要去做一个微绕。Yeah,
it's probably gonna be like new enemy types, new puzzles, new everything.
能真切感受到梦的那种自由和奇妙无比的体验。 所以在设计玩法时基于梦境这一主题展开了许许多多的想法，比如说在多维度的空间里面行走，做事重力错乱等等。Kind
of pissed me off that they walk past the chest. I'm not gonna lie.
没错，而在一个场景中呢，制作出多维度的表现效果也是我们最大的难点与挑战。我们希望通过出乎意料的游戏体感、沉浸式的氛围塑造，真正的让。
Oh, what the fuck! You can just walk up the wall just like that?
这也是崩坏星穹铁道项目组一直以来创作的初衷。 希望能持续不断的带给大家惊喜，具体的特色玩法与奇妙的战斗体验，大家也不要着急，我们将会在稍后的节目中详细介绍。Detailed
intro in the program later on. All right.
这次前往匹洛康尼的开拓旅程，远比我预想的更加丰富，有趣的程度更是超乎想象。我们大伟哥说，开发过程中我们要把抽象的梦境概念，甚至是许多关于梦境的高维设想，转化为场景的视觉表达。
What is this music in the background right now?
What the hell?
是这样的精神分析啊。好像也是有这样的事呢。不过我记得刚才白老师还提到匹诺康尼有种特殊的当地文化叫苏勒达。我看我们聊了这么多也口渴了，不如先去喝一杯吧。
好，虽然烧鸡老师十分生硬的扯开了话题啊，那我们不如稍事休息，去整点汽水喝喝。开拓者呢，也千万不要走开，接下来会带来
2.0 版本的角色和更多的讯息。
Oh yep, the characters, banners, and everything. Meanwhile, he's an ad for. Oh, and yeah, he's the first redemption code. Yeah, I don't trust this guy at all. This little Clocky, what's his name? I don't know why. After watching the Loki TV series, I do not trust animated clocks ever again. Just something's a bit off about this. But hey, there you go. Your first redemption code, everybody. Claim it quick before it expires in 12 hours. Which is, yeah, literally the expired date's like listed below there. Alright, TT9S28LK4QHP. What is this music? It's like I'm playing like a freaking Mario game or something, or Sonic game. Or like an arcade back in the freaking 90s. And we're back. Darway's the freaking bartender now.
感谢大伟哥，那么接下来请允许我为大家介绍新朋友。各位开拓者，大家好，我是。Dr.
Orange. Is that really his name?
品尝美味的苏勒达。
God, we got a lot of weird doctors in Saria, don't we?
那在刚才啊，我了解了许多有关匹诺康尼的有趣设定。那现在啊，我更加迫不及待想知道，在这方奇妙的舞台上会有哪些新同伴登场呢？
嗯，刚才我们也聊到，在家族的宴会中汇聚了形形色色代表各方势力前来的宾客，他们的立场和目的当然也各不相同嘛。那我们首先介绍这位大家期待已久的神秘来宾
，Black Swan。
黑天鹅是一位
，Don't know nothing about her. Haven't even seen a bit of lore of about her in the story.
他就已经出过场了。那时他给人的印象也是非常的擅长占卜。
I do like her design though. Even though it's just basically lingerie.
简单的了解过流光逸庭这个神秘的组织，我知道他们的信徒一直在追随着记忆星神福离。
没错。流光逸庭的译者们放弃了肉身，以录音的形式穿梭于宇宙，为星神搜集星海间最珍贵的记忆。
啊，魔音？什么
Mac entities？
魔音声是吧？当然不是这个魔音。黑天鹅对其他人的记忆非常感兴趣，他会非常耐心地聆听他们的回忆故事，然后加以收集整理，最后变作指尖的一张张纸牌。你会发现他的脸上总是挂着耐人寻味的笑容，但这只是他作为占卜师的习惯，并不一定出自真心。
Oh, yes, she's from the Garden of Recollection. Okay, so like the NPC by the Memory of Chaos. Yeah, she has a really, really pretty design. I like that she kind of floats in the air. She's got like a velvet room attendant. If you play Persona, you'll know what that means. Also, yeah, those are new enemies. Oh god, I saw one of them being like a clock, like looking enemy. I knew freaking Clocky, the Mickey Mouse clone, could be trusted. So, wait, Black Swan's gonna be played like Ching Chui?
黑天鹅是给你加个状态，等到你行动的时候再生效，这就很像先占卜，然后揭示命运。
Okay, yeah, so yeah, she's Win Nairi, like Sampo. Yeah, okay, yeah, those are brand new enemies.
在战斗中，黑天鹅使用普攻战技攻击敌人的时候，都有概率为敌人施加。
And for the Arcana Destiny card, okay, so very, very much like Velvet Room Attendant. I'm more inclined to pull for Black Swan now.
敌人身上的命运卡会升级，对敌人造成的持续伤害效果会提高。所以黑天鹅是不是会适合与持续伤害相关的角色组队搭配呢？没错，它的配对。
Oh, so it's good. She's good for dot teams. Yes. As a puller of Kafka and someone who built Sampo, and probably Green Hyphen too. Yeah, I think I'm inclined to pull for Black Swan, guys.
好牌呢，都被开拓者已经抽走了。
Whoa, look at that freaking burst or ultimate. That is cool. All the fucking hands just erupting. Oh, okay, so it's confirmed. Sparkle is a mass fool. Yeah, she really gives off Hu Tao vibes. Combine Yoimiya with all the goldfish around. Oh, Lizzie Freeman's voicing her, so it's the same voice actor does Yanfei, right? Yeah. And yeah, I think in the previous stream we also covered that Sampo is also a mask fool. I don't know why, I just find the mask fool is the most interesting faction in Saria for a reason. Where'd you get the Trailblazers bat from? Oh, right. I think I saw this somewhere else as well, but she can basically increase your skill point limit. Oh, yeah, that's a cool looking ultimate. You can have seven skill points. Okay, so she's a Harmony character. Okay. Having fucking seven skill points and just buffing Alex in general? Okay, that sounds... Okay, well, I'm torn once again between the two. Also, that skill's animation looks pretty sick, I gotta say.
被拉上来的队友是不是欢愉我不清楚，但作为玩家的我的确很欢愉。
是
开拓者也可以在2.0版
本 of companionship missions yep forgets the both of them I still need to do at least do one companionship quest before I do them. There's a lot of companionship quests I gotta catch up on. Misha, right, that's blue hair guy's name. Okay, he's a 4-star. Destruction, is that destruction? I don't know, I don't have the symbols memorized. And yeah, as weird as it seems, that is a boy.
不过暂时酒店的事情还是太过繁重了，所以尽管米莎一直在努力工作，还是免不了会出现一些意外状况，
比如不小心打翻客人的行李。
哎，这个行李车要是能来撞人一定很爽吧。
你的关注点总是特别的别致，不过咱们想到一块去了，行李车和拖把就是米莎使用的战斗方式。
Is that a skill? He literally uses his the luggage he carries as weapons. Oh, he has a mop as a weapon, really? Bro. I always feel bad for him and I don't even know him. Yeah, that is ultimate just...Dumping all the luggage on everybody. Oh, but it also freezes them as well. Okay. What? He has Zawalda? He can just freeze enemies in time? Okay, you should have began with that. Yes, banners. Okay, phase 1 just Black Swan, they're not doing 2 banners yet, and also her light cone. God damn though. Really, really focus on the booba there, I see you, Hoyo. Phase 2, okay, just Sparkle, okay, so no reruns. Sparkle's Quantum as well, which is... Slowly building my model Quantum team, honestly, with... Oh, never mind, they are bringing reruns. Okay, Downhung and Biberluna, already have them, so... no need to... My Jays are safe. Oh, Jing Yuan in Phase 2, okay. Honestly, with the new pure fiction mode, I might be tempted to pull for Jing Yuan, but Black Swan and Sparkle are there too. Oh, so... Sam's part of Stellan. Oh, so he's with Kafka, Blade, and Silver Wolf, but I've never seen him before. Wait, you fight him? Oh, he's a boss, okay. Okay, I guess Kafka, Blades, and Silver Order are not the only Stellan Hunters. Okay. I mean, the Stellan Hunters usually have, like, really, really cool personality, so I guess I'm curious to see what the Sam is all about. I like the metal armor he wears. The lordly trash cans are proud.
而作为强壮的战士，他们最为独特的地方在于没有弱点，而且常规的攻击几乎无法对王下一统造成任何的伤害。
啊，那要如何打败他们？
也是有办法。
What? They're actually enemies? What? I thought this is just a joke.
他没有弱点，他的弱点就是开拓者。
What the fuck? Okay, Hoyo, you're taking this trash can joke a bit far. What, you don't even kill it, it would just leave? Bro. Okay, Hoyo, you're taking this little trash can joke a bit too far. Knowing Hoyo and the absurdity of this, They might just create a whole ass trash can planet.
那除了这位潇洒的战士以外，开拓者也需要应对一些来自梦境的奇妙生物，比如惊梦剧团和异域民音。虽然我们已经知道了匹诺康尼是一个梦境的世界，而家族承诺这是一片美梦，但偶尔呢，梦中也会产生。
I'm still distraught by that. There's actual trash can enemies in the game now. What the fuck?
梦中的物品会在他们的影响下变成惊梦剧团。受匹诺康尼庆典氛围的影响啊，这些生物在诞生以后依然忠实地扮演着原本的角色。嗯，不过对于普通民众而言，他们演出可能已经和破坏无异了。
惊梦剧团和异域迷音啊，这俩名字听起来好像有种舞台剧的感觉，
但他们其实长得还是挺有趣的。
Oh, big monkey boy.
匹诺康尼的形容词来解释的话，
惊梦剧团。Oh, but they have police dogs for some reason. Oh, you know, they're holding the soul glad freaking stuff. Okay, then and they can attack with them apparently.
热爱分享的可爱小甜心。而原木先生原本
yeah, the freaking yeah, clock like enemy. Oh, fuck, they have an angry mode. I do not like that. Oh, so every time you hit them, it changes. Huh, that's the cool enemy design, I guess. They change every time you hit them. I guess, like, what, when they're happy, they give you buffs, when they're angry, they attack you. Whoa, what are these things? More robots, it seems. Yeah, these enemy designs look sick, honestly. I mean, they're kind of using the same animations as the previous enemies. But still, they look pretty cool nonetheless.
比方说其中的视线无处不在，它就源于视与看这两种概念，其实会贯穿我们每个人的一生。再比如我心之
Heartbreaker，
极限的是坚硬的躯壳下，往往是脆弱不堪的心灵。而其中最特别
，Holy shit, a dragon! Something unto death. Okay, so you have these wacky enemies like talking trash cans and talking clocks, and then you have a freaking eldritch horror just right in front of us.
所有见过他的人往往都没有活着回来。
其实看他的名字，他并不是单纯的死亡，而是核物朝向死亡。它是某一种更为复杂的概念的极上集合。不过现在就用暂且就用死亡来称呼他吧，也无妨。
提问：你们刚不是说匹诺康尼很安全吗？
我
们。Why are there so many enemies if the Penacony is supposedly a safe place?
朝向死亡，在战斗中
，Holy shit！
造成致命伤害。
No, John Hong, no! What?
年木节中。开拓者需要消灭。
You have to free their soul if they capture it.
所有角色都被困在了永眠木节中。
Oh, that's gonna be a bitch to handle. I can already tell.
反正不是他死就是我亡呗。
死亡是人类无法回避的议题，也是我们。
No, not my teammates.
所以我们也是想通过美术表现，围绕死亡的概念做出充足的压迫感。比方说，他身上有很多张长着眼睛一样的花纹。
Shit, that's actually fucking terrible. He can just suspend your characters until you free them.
有点瘆得慌。
和人类不同，
that just does not seem fair.
有很多眼睛，而且随着战斗的进程的推进，这些眼睛
逐
渐变成血红色。当他的三对眼睛都变成血红色的时候，就获得了能直接对角色造成致命伤害的能力。死亡无时。
So just hitting him three times will just
这就是我们在设计核物朝向死亡
make him kill somebody until and then you can revive him later on.
被怪物抓走时，空荡的肉身还留在原地，这也是我们对死亡的。
That enemy is gonna be a fucking pain to handle. I can already tell.
这么抽象内容做出来的。
不瞒大伟哥，最初讨论。
I am not looking forward to fighting that thing.
感觉很迷，因为这概念实在太抽象了，你很难想象如何把这些这么抽象的概念落到实处，而且还让玩家能感受到。所以，就比如说，用怪物来表现死亡的概念已经很抽象了。还要在此基础上展示核物朝向死亡这个概念，那实在是想破了头都不知道该表现什么。
但对于设计怪物的同学来说，随着制作 deadline 一天一天的推进，他们这种朝向死亡的感觉会愈发强烈。
听上去在研发过程中啊，项目组的同学还是经历了不少困难。
那故事可太多了。
也 maybe should give a break or something。
我们准备了一个纪录片，带大家走进星穹铁道项目组的工作日常。那不如我们先看一下预告片，顺便进入对话码时间。
Hey Phil, yeah, welcome.Yeah, imagine just like, you need to free your own character, but what if they take your only DPS? That's, yeah, that's just really, really... Yeah, I'm not sure how you're supposed to counter that. What, just bring two DPSs? But then you can also, like, kill two characters. Oh, what the hell? Also, yeah, there's a second redemptive code. Don't forget to claim it within a 12-hour period, otherwise it will go away. 100 jades. Holy shit, there's war in Hoyo. Witness the behind the scenes of Penacony. Man, this creepy ass music again. Yeah, this special program is so different from Genshin. Yeah, I was speaking against it at first, but Honkai Story just truly seems to be like the favorite child at the moment. Like, not this much love was put for Genshin. This is coming from somebody who loves Genshin, by the way. This place exists between dream and reality, mind and matter. I can't help but feel like most of this stuff is like very Persona inspired. Whoa! Punk? Is that really his name? Whoa. The fucking set pieces though. How much money was put into like just making these rooms for just for live streams?
在 2.0 版本，开拓者可以通过一种特殊能力梦客漫步，走到墙壁上，体验到世界最好的感觉。
像你刚才那样？
对，例如在节目的一开始，大家看到在梦境酒店中，开拓者可以体验到多面。
Just gravity is just not a thing anymore, apparently. In this world.
重力的转换是有存储次数的。
Oh, then store charges. Okay, so I guess this is how we're gonna solve the puzzles of in Penacony.
筑梦边境与质子的梦，筑梦边境是家族的筑梦师正在建造的地方。简单来说，就是施工工地。
Yeah, who is the family? Is it any of those characters we saw earlier? I have no idea who this family is, by the way. Oh, it's like Fischl's domain. Yeah, with optical illusions and whatnot. Yeah, just give me heavy Fischl domain vibes. Oh, yeah, and then you actually have to solve a puzzle.
比如你能直接拼出一个宝箱、一个机关、一个 NPC， 甚至可以直接拼出一个前行的区域，开启之前无法通行的道路。而在
这次的梦中，开拓者可以使用能力在一处梦境世界中最大的场景中进行探索体验。Compared to the other places, I can't wait for it.
其实，在 2.0 版本，我们也准备了非常丰富的活动，比如哈努兄弟越狱记活动中。
Oh, this is like one of the events. Hanu Prison Break.
那哈鲁兄弟和钟表小子一样，是匹诺康尼经常出现的一位动画角色。
是的，在活动中，开拓者会在。
Yeah, mostly it's more the producers of Genshin and the developers that just make it look greedy. And like, yeah, not give out as many free rewards as most gacha games should.
引发了众怒，开拓者不仅要帮助自己和狱友越狱，还要肩负起抢夺美梦监狱控制
权，带着大家获得
新生的责任。
燃起来了，那具体要怎么做呢？
首先，开拓者要将自己作为人肉弹珠机
，we're gonna play pinball，
速度与激情的戏码，驾驶囚笼逃出升天，然后利用镜面迷宫中的移动模块和
镜子的倒影。Okay, these puzzles are gonna rack my brain dry.
接下来，开拓者还要变身为迷你版的哈努兄弟。
What the fuck?
通过典狱长石头老板的重重封锁，拿到监狱密钥，获得监狱控制权，
All the shit is just so wacky. I don't think you can explain it to me. I think I need to experience this for myself to truly understand what the hell's going on.
在支离破碎的梦境空间中上下翻转，自由行走，找到分散在走墙房间中的狱友，共同赢得最后的决战。在前面这些梦套测试完成后，开拓者可以在多名四星角色中任选其一作为。
Oh, you can choose between sample. Okay.
这些奖励应该。
My great knife is actually not max Elon's yet, so maybe I'll get her.
虽然哈努兄弟。
But you come though.
这段梦套故事是虚构的。但我保证各位开拓者获得的快乐以及奖励一定是真实的。
梦境是自由的，在 2.0 版本的任务中，开拓者。
But okay, but all I know is that my sample is E6 already, so I don't need another sample.
人是情感的动物，会在情感的指引下做出选择。
Oh, what the fuck?
情绪而困扰，各位开拓者可以帮助他们疏解心中的苦闷，或是让他们平凡的一天过得与众不同。
So we need to figure out like how they're feeling, and then help them.
在游戏中自行体会，但是想提醒一下大家，人类的情感。
I'm guessing this is all part of the event, right?
Yeah. 大家认真对待手中的选择权。
好的，匹诺康尼的这些新玩法的确很有梦境的味道。其中啊，我还是最好奇那个走墙的玩法。不知道项目组的同学为什么选择了这个玩法作为设计重点呢？
一方面是觉得能在墙面和天花板上行走是人类很常见的一种梦境体验，这个玩法可以最大程度引起大家对于梦的共鸣。而另一方面嘛，毕竟我们的场景做得如此精致漂亮，这么好看的地图只让大家踩在地面上未免过于浪费了。我们希望开拓者的足迹能够遍布匹诺康尼的更多地点，看到更多在现实世界中无法看到的场景。
能跟游戏内的场景进行更加丰富的这个交互互动啊，想必也是花费了不少的心力啊。
也没有吧，你看我今年20，做完匹诺康尼以后，
wait, you just, wait, you're 20?
气色也变好了。
啊，好吧，那么
I do not believe that man is 20.
什么样的惊喜呢？
进入新世界之初，
I must be reading that wrong.
开拓者在梦境世界中的各种体验、有趣的剧情都可以用它来记录。大家可以通过主线任务、城市探索等方式获取记录剧情的专属贴纸，来装饰你的护照本。随着剧情与探索的深入，护照也会解锁越来越
多丰富的界面。You can decorate your whatever with pictures of you of the other characters.
按照自己的喜好做出美观的护照本啦。
哎，这个给人的感觉很像在游乐园里收集印章。
没错，匹诺康尼就是一座巨大的游乐园。我们希望每一位开拓者都能在其中找到乐趣，留下美好的开拓记忆。为了让开拓者尽快熟悉
another event, Dream Chaser Bulletin.
我们还推出了逐梦客实训限时活动，在前往匹诺康尼的
Whoa, what the fuck?
一份花边小报被不知名人士
Okay, it just seems like bounty hunting. Is that a freaking mechanical dinosaur for chef hat?
别吧，有奖励。
Oh, it is. What the fuck?
跟随指引完成指定的探索。
I can appreciate how weird and wacky Hoyo decides to take the Honkai Sario enemies.
惊险刺激的惊梦电视台战斗活动也将会与
Dream Jolt TV. Okay, I guess these are all like the filler events.
惊梦剧团开的吗？
不不不，他们没有合法执照。匹诺康尼电视台信号被金梦电视台劫持，所以导播拜托开拓者与金梦电视台进行战斗，从金梦电视台手中夺回电视信号，实现
the freaking pointing of the
高端的商战往往都以最朴素的形式展开。
Yeah, that American poster, which I forgot the name of.
异变机制与不同的成员进行挑战，获取更高的战斗分数。
其实我很好奇啊。
No, I wonder why Lord's just not getting a rerun though. Because isn't he like the, Yeah, one of the more recent, Sario banners? Oh wait, or did Lord's already have a rerun and I just forgot about it? I don't know.
大家都知道，出来旅游嘛，除了知名地标打卡，吃吃买买也是非常重要的旅行体验。最近呢，匹诺康尼展开了旅游推广活动。希望能够通过
Penacony Food Fest
加强对外宣传，从而带动匹诺。
Oh, I guess we get recipes for this.
在 2.0 版本的匹诺康尼美食庆典活动中，开拓者可以前往钟表餐厅参与美食活动。在活动中
，Yeah, Penacony just looks so lively.
定原材料交给。
Oh, yeah,
man,
we do have to make food there.
加工食材，并给予开拓者相应的奖励。
We're essentially becoming a dine and dash or food panda.
你们人怪好的。
在 2.0 版本，我们还有全新的材料会和大家见面。 先来看看我们的橱窗上新。
Oh, new artifacts, relics. I mean, I keep referring to gadget terms.
穿上这套仪器的角色，能对受负面状态影响的敌人造成更高的伤害。
Ah, so like a Dr. Ratio said, okay. Increases the break effect for the team. Okay, so that could be good for like Ranmei and Shuei.
在新的版本还新增了量子属性
角色进阶材料 more materials you have to go out and collect
以及冰属性角色进阶材料冷藏梦乡
oh no these are essential materials oh because yeah the shit you get from the bosses
也将新增毁灭虚无同邪三个命途的行迹材料2.0 版本的三个角色会使用到这些新材料
Yeah, but of course the 2.0 characters use these materials So you can pre-farm
忘却之庭和虚构叙事的商店在新版本也更新了
Wait, this new icon's coming to
开拓者可以使用代币获取它们
Oh shit, okay, well then I should probably save up my, my things then Wait, is this for the, battle pass Or this is, like, free icons coming to Forgotten Hall
全新的光锥能帮助到大家的开拓之旅
与此同时
I need to take a look at that again
开拓者的反馈和意见在之前的版本中呢我们一直在根据大家的反馈对游戏体验方面进行优化我们始终觉得系统方面的优化或许没有更新版本活动那么直观但它其实是游戏的地基优化一些系统功能也许放在整个游戏里很小不太起眼但是却能带给开拓者更便捷舒心的体验我们希望让每一位开拓者都有舒适顺心的游戏体验而不是让一些交互体验上的小石子成为大家开拓路上各脚的负担
项目组的同学有心了所以在 2.0 版本中啊也会有系统方面的优化与我们见面吗
没错那我先来说下与
剧情相关的 New Fates Atlas System OK so QOL
我们将推出一个梳理游戏故事线的功能命路歧途
Oh, so timeline. So a timeline. That's kind of nice. Basically shows you the order of events. In case you decide to go ahead and play them out of order.
通过这个功能，开拓者会更加清晰地了解自己目前正在进行哪些任务，更好地理解发生在这个世界的剧情。
Okay, that might be good for me then, because I'm massively behind.
有了这个功能，开拓者
then I know which ones to play first, just so I can play them in a chronological order.
但每一位开拓者依然可以决定如何抵达那个目的地。
我又要说出那句话了。当我们有机会做出选择的时候，不要让自己后悔。
Okay, so it's canonical that Ranmei shows up before you go to Reelo 6? Oh, you can put more support characters. Oh, that's cool. And you can show off more of the characters you wailed for. Oh, sweet. Now I can bookmark that guy's Jing Liu and just keep using him.
是的，除此之外，仪器的升级也会迭代。在升级时，可以更为便捷的置入材料，将仪器升级到指定等级，也能更快速的进行筛选，对上好的材料进行快速的分类。那我们还新增了针对不同角色的仪器套装搭配推荐，开拓者可以
在
筛选推荐套装
中
迅速切换。同时更新了仪器标记气质和分解方面的优化，提高了查找养成材料的便捷性。
嗯。相信在清理了这些小石子之后啊，开拓者在匹洛康尼的开拓之旅会更加愉快。
请大家放心，我们将持续关注反馈，在系统优化这块只有大家想不到的
和策划想不到的。
嗯，好吧，也感谢两位同学。
Surprise the designers! What?
那现在让我们稍作休息，稍后还有更多精彩等着大家。
Okay, wow, they really covered a lot. What else is there to talk about? Unless it's like this is the end. Because this is the last redemption code. Once again, claim it before they expire in 12 hours. Complete a trailblaze mission. Oh, yeah, that's just the beginning trailblaze mission to unlock the mailbox function and receive the redemption code mail. Yeah. It does look like a pretty stacked special program so far.I'm definitely going to be making use of that quest chronological order thing. Just a better copy of the story. Because, yeah, if you guys don't know, I did play the quest out of order. I did the Hua Hua Trailblaze mission, and then afterwards I did Ethereum Wars, which you're supposed to do the other way around. Because Ethereum Wars is where you meet Gwei Knifey for the first time. But then when you start the the Huohua Trailblaze quest, she acts like you've already met. And I was like, what? We never met before. What are you guys talking? What are you talking about? Now I know how to properly play like these things in order. At least I hope I will know. I'm assuming we've reached the end of this special program. Hot damn, though. This is my first time watching a Star Rail special program, and yeah, it was fucking awesome, especially that freaking cinematic at the beginning with Da Wei being, I don't know, tripping balls or something. Yep, free 10 wishes! Shit you'll never get in Genshin!
没错, 不仅如此, 大家还可以通过戳心之礼签到活动,
再领取10连抽。 Oh, gives a star rail, wait.
在2.0版本中啊, 大家可以通过签到活动,
really? Just 23 wishes just like that from checking in? Alright. Festival invitation event will also become available. Oh, this is just like... So I think it's like a web event where you can like customize what shit you want. Oh, wait. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that seems like a web event.
受梦境溢出的影响, 现实中也将出现一些匹诺康尼的景象。
竹子, 你的意思是?
从2月开始, 匹诺康尼的梦境将会逐渐降临在世界各地。 开拓者将有机会在现实中体验到匹诺康尼的部分风土人情。
Oh, this is like actual real world events. I saw like Taipei and stuff. As if what? Is that, isn't there gonna be like Star Rail, like booths all around the world? Travel Mystery. Oh, just yeah. Free rewards you can win if you go to these places.
相信在听过这么多介绍之后啊, 开拓者一定都对匹诺康尼迫不及待了。 赶快邀请小伙伴一起入住吧！话说回来啊，最近梦境世界的游客增加啊，我听说匹诺康尼的电视台也更新了新的节目内容。大卫跟你的消息真是太灵通了！在近期，我们将推出经典的动画。
A classic animated short film, clocking his friends.
相信经过之前的介绍啊，
huh. Okay, so it's our introduction to Clocky, whoever this guy is.
匹诺康尼电视台的收视率。是的。
让我们期待这部来自匹诺康尼的经典动画短片，一同感受钟表小子精彩又有趣的冒险。在新年即将到来之际，
that's a cute little image of Gui and Su Shang.
准备了一场精彩的表演。Oh,
wait. Oh, another anime short with them both? For Chinese New Year? Damn, that's already more than they're doing for the Lantern, right?
你说仙州罗湖的朋友们也会一起包饺子吗？
我觉得他们应该会一起串穷吃鸟串，很喜庆啊！在节目的最后，我们还有重磅消息要带给开拓者，就由大卫哥你来揭晓吧。What?
首先是，What is this big? We'll be hosting offline carnivals around the world.
是的，我们真的非常非常期待与开拓者的线下相见。Oh,
so in real life? 嘉年华崩坏新穷铁道。Ooh, a Honkai Star Rail concert.
预计也是在今年的年中。
I did miss on the Genshin concert, so I maybe would like to catch on this one.
好，那么崩坏星穹铁道 2.0 前瞻特别节目到这里就结束了。非常感谢各位开拓者的收看。皮洛康尼的故事将在二月
Live on 6 February. Ah shit, that's around the same time where Genshin's Lantern Ride goes up. Ah shoot, I'm gonna have to prioritize Genshin first, but eventually I do want to go to Penacony.
请大家尽情期待新世界，匹诺康尼。
Wish you a good dream.
Wow, yeah, this was a really, really stacked special program. I honestly did not know what to expect going into a Honkai Star Rail special program, but this went above and beyond. Holy shit. It's so different from everything I experienced in the Genshin special programs. Oh, man. Okay, well, that is it, everybody. That is it for the version 2.0 special program for Honkai Star Rail. Man, oh. I really, really want to play Peacony so bad, but there's also the Lantern Run I'm looking much forward to, but yeah, damn. I will try my best. My best is to, like, try and catch up on everything in Star Rail before Genshin 4.4, but then, yeah. Eventually, when it comes out, I think I'll do Genshin 4.4 first, and then Penacony, like, afterwards, because I can't be in two places at one now, can I? But yes, I think I'll prioritize Genshin first, and then Honkai Star Rail afterwards, but yeah. That is it for the Honkai Star Rail 2.0 special program. Honestly, I'm hyped. This is my first time attending one of these special programs, and yeah, I'm hyped for 2.0, honestly. But yeah, guys, what do you think about the 2.0 special program of Honkai Star Rail? Are you going to be pulling for Black Swan or Sparkle? And yeah, let me know in the comments down below. What are you most excited about in version 2.0? But yeah, guys, that about does it for my reaction to the version 2.0 special program of Honkai Star Rail. Leave a like on the stream if you enjoyed my reaction. Leave a comment down below. Let me know your thoughts on 2.0, and subscribe today if you do see more videos or streams from me. Like I said, over probably the next few days, I'll be streaming Star Rail. On Monday, actually, I'll be actually watching every Star Rail trailer that has been released so far. Like, starting from the very first Star Rail trailer, which I think is like the beta one, or Sealess trailer. Or no, or what is it, Bailu's trailer? I don't know. Starting from the beginning and then all the way to current times with the Star Rail trailers, I'm going to be watching them all on Monday and hoping to get through all of them on that day. And yeah, sometime down the line, I think I also watch or not watch, but play Star Rail and do the Dr. Ratio Trailblaze mission. At the very least, I'm going to complete all the Trailblaze missions before Penacony comes out. So I think I'll do that. And then maybe if I have time on that same day, we'll also try and finish up several story quests, which I did start, but forgot to. But yeah, never never continued on with it. And also maybe downhunting a bit of Luna's story. Commander ship quest as well. And yes, as I said, I also am streaming on Twitch at twitch.tv as Spacish360. Follow me on Twitch if you want to see me play some non-Hoyo games like Persona 3 Reload and Yakuza Kiwami 2 and any other games I plan to stream on there and whatnot. But yeah, that'll be it for me for today, guys. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you guys again in the next one. Take care and have good nights, and I wish you all the best in your polls and your fun in Penacony in version 2.0 when it does come out. But yeah, that'll be it for me for today, guys. See ya!